This is question number 5, exercise 4.2. And this is a word problem. The question is, the altitude of a right triangle is 7 cm less than its base. Now, if the hypotenuse is 13 cm, find the other two sides. So, the question is about a right angle triangle. Think of a right angle triangle. Okay. Now, it is given that the altitude of a right triangle is 7 cm less than the base. So, whatever the length of the base, the altitude, the perpendicular will be 7 cm less than that. Alright. Then, the hypotenuse is 13 cm. The hypotenuse is 13 cm. So, this hypotenuse is 13 cm. Question is, find the other two sides. You need to find the length of these two sides. Now, since it is saying that the altitude is 7 cm less than the base. So, altitude is dependent on the base. We need to take the dependent variable from the independent variable. So, the independent thing is the base. Okay, because it is not dependent on any of the sides. But altitude is dependent on the base. So, what we'll do? Let this base be x. Now, if the base is x, it is saying altitude is 7 cm less. Altitude is 7 cm less than the base. So the altitude perpendicular will be this altitude, the perpendicular will be 7 cm less than the base. So it will be 7 cm less means minus 7. Then what? Then the base. And the base is x minus 7. So what did you get? Let the base be x, and then the altitude will be x minus 7, and already the hypotenuse is given. So we start like that. Let the base be x and let the base be x. Okay, therefore its altitude means the altitude of the triangle is equal to x minus 7. You can write it in centimeter. Okay, now see the remaining part, nothing else is given other than the length of the hypotenuse. Only the length of the hypotenuse is given. In other questions, when we are doing this, we got a particular situation on which we form the equation. Now, no particular situation is given, but one thing you must understand that this triangle is a right angle triangle. So, although no particular situation is given, what you can do? We can use the Pythagoras theorem for this right angle triangle. Okay? Therefore, because once again I repeat this, why we are using the Pythagoras theorem? Because no particular situation is given for a question other than this, okay, other than the length. So we are going to use the Pythagoras theorem. Therefore, by Pythagoras theorem, we have write the Pythagoras theorem. This is p square plus b square equal to h square, p4 perpendicular. So this perpendicular is altitude, how much? X minus 7 whole square plus b is the base, and the base is x, so x square is equal to h square. H means the hypotenuse, so this is 13 square. Now we will simplify this equation and we will get the required quadratic equation from here. Now let us do it. This x minus 7 whole square is simply a minus b whole square. So this is your a square minus twice ab twice x into 7 plus b square minus 7 square plus here x square is equal to 13 square. 13 square is 169. This implies now x square plus x square, this is 2x square minus 2 7s are 14x. Here we have 7 square is 49. 169 is on the left, minus 169 is equal to 0. Okay, this implies this is your twice x squared minus 14x and plus minus minus 169 minus 49 will be 120. So 120 is equal to 0. For easy doing, you take 2 common from here, it will be x squared minus 7x. Okay, 7 to the 14 minus 60 is equal to 0. This implies this is your x square minus 7x minus 60 equal to 2 multiply here, actually will divide. So 0 by 2 is 0. Now, to find the value of x, let us use the factorization method once again and get the value of x from here, and we use the factorization method, means this 7x we are going to split. Okay, for that, once again, this 1 and this 60 should be multiplied. 1 into 60 is 60. Let us prime factorize by 2, this is 30, by 3, this is 10, and by 2 again, 2, 5 is 10. Now, look at the numbers, 2 into 2 into 3 into 5. These 4 factors should be converted to 2 in such a way that we get number 7 from here. 2 gets 7, you know, this sign is minus, so we need to minus these numbers and get what is that? 7 from here. So for that, we try in different ways. 2 is a 4 and 3, 5 is a 15. 15 minus 4. 15 minus 4 is 11, not 7. So it will not work like this. Then you try the other way. Suppose 2, 3 is a 6. 2, 3 is a 6. 2, 5 is a 10. 10 minus 6 is 4. It will not come, okay? So try in all possible ways, we will get the answer from there. Now, 2 to the 4, 4 to the 12. 2 to the 4, 4 to the 12, and 5 to the 12 minus 5 is 7. So we get the numbers 12 and 5, whose difference is this number 7. Alright? So let us write this term. For 7, so we got 7 equal to 12 minus 5. 7 equal to 12 minus 5x minus 60 is equal to 0. This implies x squared minus plus minus 12x minus minus plus 5x minus 60 equal to 0. So you take x common from here, you take x common, you know, x minus 12 plus 5 you take common from here, again x minus 12 is equal to 0. Now, both the terms are having x minus 12, so x minus 12 you take common. If you take x minus 12 common, we have x left here, here we have left 5. So 5 equal to 0. So 5 equal to 0. This is 5. Okay, this is your 5. This implies, Now, their product is 0, so either x minus 12 is 0. Or x plus 5 equal to 0. Is it okay? Now if you find the value of x, x equal to 12, or here we will get x equal to minus 5. Now, since the value of x, it is the length of base and altitude, so length cannot be negative. That is why this minus 5 we need to reject. It cannot be your answer. So we have to write this minus 5 is rejected. So our accepted answer is 12. Okay, so therefore, x you have considered for the base, therefore, the base of the triangle is equal to 12 cm. Alright, and the altitude, we have taken x minus 7. X minus 7 means x just now we got 12. So 12 minus 7 equal to 5 cm. Okay, so these are the required lengths. Alright, thank you.